Hello friends, the topic for today is internet and web terms and definitions. First, let us understand what is internet. The internet is a global system of interconnected computer networks that uses internet protocol suite TCP/IP to link devices worldwide. It is a network of networks that consists of local to global scope linked by a broad array of electronics, wireless and optical networking technologies. So here we use different networking technologies such as wireless, optical fiber and wired or cable technology. The internet carries a vast range of information resources and services such as interlinked hypertext documents and applications of the World Wide Web, WWW, then electronic email, telephone and file share. So these are the various information resources on the internet. Then let us understand what is World Wide Web. The World Wide Web, WWW, is an internet-based service which uses common set of rules known as protocols to distribute documents across the internet in a standard way. The World Wide Web or web is a part of the internet. The web is viewed through web browser softwares such as Google Chrome, Internet Explorer, Mozilla, Firefox, etc. Using browsers, one can access digital libraries containing innumerable articles, journals, e-books, news tutorials stored in the form of web pages on computers around the world called web servers. Today, thousands of web pages or websites are added to the World Wide Web every hour. Then let us understand the difference between internet and WWW or World Wide Web. The internet is known as the interconnection of computer networks, and the internet is a massive network of networks. It connects millions of computers together globally, forming a network in which any computer can communicate with any other computer as long as they are both connected to the internet. Information that travels over the internet does so via a variety of languages known as protocols. The World Wide Web, or web for short, or simply web, is a massive collection of digital pages to access information over the internet. The web uses HTTP protocol to transmit data and allows applications to communicate in order to exchange business logic. Web also uses browsers such as Internet Explorer, Firefox to access web documents called web pages that are linked to each other via hyperlinks. Web documents also contain graphics, sound, text and video. So this way the internet and World Wide Web, they are different. So World Wide Web is a part of internet. This you must understand. Then let us go to the domain name. A domain name is a unique name, for example, google.com, used to identify the location of a website on the web server. When you access a website through web browser like Google Chrome, the domain name is translated to an internet protocol, that is IP address. For example, 172.217.12.206. So this is a IP address, so which represents the server on which the website is hosted. This translation is dynamically performed by a domain name server, that is DNS. Let us see what is domain name server. Domain name servers are internet's equivalent of a phone book or directory. They keep an updated list of domain names and translate them back into IP address. This is necessary because although domain names are easy for humans to remember, computers, which include all devices that can connect to the internet, use IP address to access website. So here we include the laptops, then mobile phones, PDA, etc. Then let us understand IP address, internet protocol address. IP address is a unique number used to identify the computer on the internet. If you are connected to the internet, you must have a unique network number, which is an IP address. An example of IP address: 207.168.6.12. There are four numbers separated by a dot and are between 0 and 250. The reason is, here we use the 8 bits to represent these numbers. So that's why the numbers are 0 to 255 in decimal. In hexadecimal, it will be 00 to FF. Then let us go to the hypertext. Hypertext is a text on the web page that links to another document or web page. The hypertext link can be as small as a letter or word, or as big as the text on the page. Then let us go to the uniform resource locator, URL. URLs or uniform resource locators are the web browser's addresses of the internet pages and files. It is the way to locate a file or document on the internet. The URL specifies the address of a file, and every file on the internet has a unique address. It works with IP addresses to give a name location to a web page. Web software such as your browser use the URL to retrieve a file from the computer on which it resides. Format of a URL. So it has protocol, colon, then backslashes, then site address, then single backslash, path, and then backslash again, and file name. Every URL has three parts to address on a page or file. First is the protocol, which ends with a double slash. Then host computer, which ends with a web extension such as .com, .org, etc. Then third is file name or a page name, which displays the related information. For example, so here HTTP, this is the protocol, then colon double slash and www.banks.com, this is the site address, and then login slash password.html. URL consists of protocol HTTP, host computer name www, domain name banks, domain type com, and then path slash login, then file name password.html. Then let us go to the web page. A simple text file created using the HTML, hypertext markup language, is nothing but the web page. Then website. The collection of web pages on the World Wide Web that is accessed by its own internet address is called a website. For example, Amazon.in. You must be knowing this website. This is the website of Amazon India. Each website contains a home page and contains other additional pages. Each website is owned and updated by individual, company, or an organization. Then let us go to the web browser. A web browser is a software used to view web pages or websites available on the internet. Some of the most popular web browsers include Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Safari, Internet Explorer, Edge, and Opera. As with all software applications, web browsers have different features and functionality, appealing to a different user type. Then let us go to the web server. What is a server? A server is a computer that provides data to other computers. The entire structure of the internet is based on a client-server model. Clients are attached to the server, and the server provides data to the clients. A web server helps to deliver web content that can be accessed through the internet. The most common use of web server is to host websites, as the internet is not only used to fetch the information, but there are other uses such as gaming, data storage, or running business applications. So as per the need, the websites are created. Now let us see the diagram. So here we have the web server, which is Apache web server, and it is connected to the internet, and the clients are connected here. You can see the first client is Mac OS, that is the Apple computer. Then we have the PDA, personal digital assistant, then laptop and the personal computer. Then the web server also has a Oracle database. Here JavaScript files, they are stored inside the server. The primary job of a web server is to deliver web pages to the clients. The communication between the client node and the server node takes place using the hypertext transfer protocol, HTTP. The delivered web pages include images, style sheets and scripts in addition to text content. The functionality of a website is managed by web server. For example, Apache, Nginx, ISS, etc. Then let us go to the HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Website consists of an array of contents like images and text, as well as interactive elements like forms, games and animation. To render the desired result, your web browser relies on programming languages, primarily HTML, hypertext markup language, then CSS and JavaScript to accomplish what is required. So here we see the figure. The HTML is used for the structure. Then the CSS is used for the presentation and JavaScript is used for the functionality. Let us see the HTML. Hypertext markup language is a coding language used to tell a browser how to place pictures, text and multimedia and links to create a web page. When a user clicks on a link within a web page, that link, which is coded with HTML, links the user to a specific link web page. Then let us go to the CSS. CSS is nothing but cascading style sheets used to give your website its style. Fonts, color, sizes, spacing, borders, background and shadows are just a few examples of what can be adjusted using the CSS. Then let us go to the JavaScript. JavaScript is a client-side programming language, which means the source is processed by client's web browser rather than on the web server. This allows the language to run actions on a page after a page has been fully loaded. An example would be sending an error message if there are missing forms fields without having to submit the request to the web server. With this, we come to the end of this video. If you like the video, press the like button, share with your friends and subscribe to our channel Engineering and Technology for You. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notifications for our future videos. Then thanks for watching. Have a nice day.